A world powered by the blockchain is being formed right in front of our eyes. Experts are calling it the Internet 3.0, the next digital revolution. It's leaving many investors and even institutions looking for a path to take an early position in this massive opportunity. Bitcoin, Ethereum, Ripple, Dash, it's all speculation at this point. But what is certain is that the most profitable businesses for cryptocurrency and the blockchain is in the actual creation of these coins. This is why some of the top early adopters of Bitcoin, blockchain miners, fund managers, and even billionaires have come together to create a new vehicle to invest in the blockchain core itself. Get immediate access to this new company by going to crushthestreet.com/Bitcoin.
Hello, everyone, and welcome into crushthestreet.com. I'm Kenneth Ameduri. It's been an interesting week, to say the least. A week in Bitcoin is like a month. A day is like a week. Things are moving very, very fast, and sentiment is changing on a dime. And that's something I've been talking about here on the show and asking different guests in this rising Bitcoin cryptocurrency environment. What is it going to feel like when things possibly turn around? Are we fully turning around? Is this just a correction? I'd love to hear what you guys think. I am certainly not making a video about the end of cryptocurrencies, but this is a significant correction. This will be one we talk about months down the line here. Although we could see new highs in the very near future, or maybe this is the start of a bear market in cryptocurrencies. I'd love to get your thoughts on that. It doesn't change the fact that the technology and the fundamental use case for cryptocurrencies is still there. I don't believe that it's Beanie Babies and worth nothing. Like a previous guest I had on the show, we discussed the value of Bitcoin and if it actually has any intrinsic value. And a lot of people say it doesn't. In fact, they say Beanie Babies are worth more because at least a Beanie Baby is worth 99 cents as a stuffed animal. And Bitcoin is worth nothing with, I think, a very limited paradigm that some of these people look at it. But nonetheless, I wanted to talk about the bubble mentality. And that's one of the things I talked about with Bob, who was adamantly against Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, calling them Beanie Babies, saying it's a tulip bubble. It's the worst, biggest bubble we've ever seen in our lifetime. And what does the turnaround feel like? And it's interesting because markets tend to take the elevator, well, I should say the markets tend to take the stairs up and the elevator down. Now, in Bitcoin's case, we actually saw Bitcoin take a rocket ship up. So what does that mean for the downtrend? Well, we're certainly seeing it pull back quickly. We saw thousands of dollars down overnight, the rest of the cryptocurrency space moving down with it as well. And I think a lot of us are questioning it, you know, if you're honest with yourself. And that's why you have to take a step back and say, hey, did you take some money off of the table when you had your big gains? Did you at least take your initial investment off of the table and solidify some of these gains and leave some exposure, leave some money on the table that you're willing to lose or at least don't need to pay the bills for next week's rent or whatever, next month's rent? I think that's something important and something level-headed people have done. Congratulations if you were one of those people who put it all on the line at $200 Bitcoin and have become cryptocurrency millionaires. I know there's a lot of people like that, and you know, you might have a different opinion on putting everything on the line. But for somebody who played it a little more conservatively, definitely don't be playing with money that you can't afford to lose. That's just me, you know. But everyone needs to make their own decisions on this. Is it time to buy the dip? Yeah, you know what? If you believe in the future of cryptocurrencies, this is a good time to get in. Or maybe wait for the chips to settle in this craziness right now, because we're seeing it go up and down by thousands of dollars. And is the bottom in yet? We don't really know. Is Bitcoin going to settle at 7,000? Is Ethereum going to settle at 500 or 400 or 300 before it settles and then starts to trend back up? Or are we going to be in this bear market type of phase for a little while where it just doesn't do much at all? I'd love to hear what you guys think about that. Something to note is that at the open, when the CME futures allowed Bitcoin and, you know, the Bitcoin platform was added to the exchange, the price of Bitcoin fell, and that correlated pretty much with the top of Bitcoin. And you can look at this chart here. Trader Steph put this together. You can follow her. She's a contributor for crushthestreet.com. Puts out a lot of great work, a lot of hard work. And she made this chart here, and you can see the CME open, 6 p.m. This was the first trading day, and a thousand point bike in the price of Bitcoin out of the gate of the futures trading. So kind of interesting. Is it coincidental? I know a lot of people have said it's low volume. You know, last night we saw the big leg down, you know, as the futures started to trade again. Does it have to do with the market being manipulated? I don't know. Or is it just simply a time for a pullback? Or is it just like the pullback we saw from 3,000 to 2,000 or 5,000 to 3,000 and then we see new highs? This time it does feel a little different. I will be honest with everybody. We are obviously at very high prices. We are starting to hear about Bitcoin all over the place. Coinbase is going crazy. You know, tons of people downloading the app now. You have gardeners and housekeepers and taxi cab drivers asking and talking about Bitcoin now. It has become a frenzy. And, you know, you can justify it and say that we're still in the early stages of Bitcoin. And I absolutely believe that. But I think it's fair to say that we were due for a big correction, and that's what we have right now. And I think that is very healthy. I don't think that this is the end of Bitcoin. This isn't the end of the POG phase or the Beanie Baby phase or Pokemon. This is just a correction. You know, maybe it plays itself out over a longer time than we've seen. I mean, we've just gotten used to seeing cryptocurrency gains and on our positions play out overnight. Literally, you know, that's what people are doing. They're getting into some cryptocurrency play and seeing hundreds of percent returns in days. Like, when else have you ever expected to invest in something to see, you know, hundreds and thousands of percent gains within a few days or weeks? You know, normally investments play out over a longer period of time, and we've gotten into this frenzy in the cryptocurrency space. So certainly I think it's healthy what we're seeing right now. I guess another thing that, you know, is everyone's scratching their head about and wondering if this is a little bit of a top is community leader Satoshi Lite on Twitter, Charlie Lee. I interviewed him here on Crush the Street, founder of Litecoin, big proponent of Bitcoin Core. And he came out and said he's selling all of his Litecoin. And he took the noble road and publicly said that it's because he doesn't want to be responsible for manipulating the market, and that he will be donating the proceeds to charity. Again, the noble cause, not sending a panic into the market by saying, I think this is the top for Litecoin, or we're in just a general cryptocurrency top here and I want to take my profits, which I think the someone who's honest with themselves, that might be a big reason why he finally sold. I mean, I remember personally, and I know people that go back further than I do, I remember when Litecoin was trading at 10 cents, and I don't even know what it was out of the gate when it first started trading and how much money this guy had. But just from 10 cents to, you know, over $300 that he was able to sell out of his position, I mean, that is an enormous gain. I mean, the understatement of the year is that he solidified his financial life for good, and that he, you know, he doesn't need his financial success to be tied to, you know, the growth of Litecoin anymore. But you know what? To be fair, who can blame him for taking profits? I mean, he was obviously, I can't imagine him having anything close to any other assets that he'd be exposed to more than Litecoin, given the situation of it. And who can fault the guy for taking money off the table, redistributing it across some different types of assets or real estate and precious metals, and just diversifying it? Because gosh, the guy is sitting on some huge gains, and I don't fault the guy for that. But does that also signal a possible top in the cryptocurrency space? And, you know, given the events overnight, we are seeing a big correction, and it correlates pretty closely. It also, a lot of people are wondering why his decision to sell Litecoin correlated so closely with the Bitcoin Cash addition to Coinbase, and what that did, and how that started to pull down Bitcoin some, and Bitcoin Cash got pumped up, and was there any sort of conspiracy going on there, and was there any sort of insider trading going on? I'd love to get your guys' thoughts in the comments on that. But you know, a lot of uncertainty, fear, uncertainty, doubt, and very, very high valuations in the cryptocurrency space spelled for a correction. And I'm curious to see how the chips settle on this. And I think it was due. This is healthy. I think everyone was a little uneasy seeing how much cryptocurrency has ran so quickly, so fast. So the pullback is good, especially if we start to build some support here and we start to trend higher. We'll all be very happy that it did pull back and there's a new base of support and not just this crazy run-up with no support from, you know, $5,000 or, you know, $3,000 from that pullback. So I'd love to get you guys' comments on that. Pretty interesting stuff here. You know, what do you guys think about Litecoin? Is Litecoin still a great investment? I tend to think so. I mean, there's speculation that Litecoin might even be used on Facebook's platform. And what a tremendous amount of marketing that will happen if Litecoin is used on Facebook, with almost everyone on Facebook. What a huge endorsement for Litecoin on that, despite Charlie Lee's exit of Litecoin. And I don't want to say that I'm accusing Charlie Lee of anything. I don't think he did anything wrong. And, you know, it's totally fair for him to do that. But, you know, his exiting of Litecoin completely, without even leaving a little bit on the table, sends a message that I think everyone is scratching their head about. But again, I'd like to get your guys' thoughts on this. Hope everyone is not panicking too much and has been able to take some profits and solidify some of these gains, and isn't risking anything they aren't willing to lose in this volatile environment. I congratulate those people who've been able to put 100% of their investment in into cryptocurrencies, especially at the early stages, and see it completely turn around their lives. Good for you. You know, for the rest of you who, you know, depend a little more on your savings and are, you know, a little more concerned about the upwards and downwards move, don't invest more than you're willing to lose. Hopefully you can at least take out your initial investment and let the rest ride. But having said that, we will be updating you guys very soon, very shortly. Everyone have a Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Signing off now.